For clarity, a file system is essentially the system by which the permanent storage space of a device is organized and divided up to hold files. The type of file system a machine has is determined by the operating system running on that machine. For iPhones and iPads, this operating system is called iOS, and similar to the operating system running on Macs, it dictates a Unix-based file system made up of a hierarchy of directories. With the primary goals of security and simplicity in mind, the file system for iOS was conceived with the notion of treating all apps as self-contained, independent islands. Each app, when it's installed, is placed in what's called a sandbox, or self-contained area of the file system in which to keep all of its stuff. You can imagine a new app on your device as a new student at a school. Let's call her Abigail. The new student is given a locker to keep books, papers, personal items, and whatever else. The locker is locked, so only this student has access to her own things. Likewise, the student doesn't have access to any fellow students' lockers. The only thing is, imagine that this is a magical school, and that the lockers maintain magical properties. There is an overall finite amount of space that all the lockers combined can take up. But until that space limit is reached, each student's locker will expand to fit whatever is put into it, or new lockers can be created. Whereas if a student has to store a gym bag and large textbooks, as long as the overall locker system has extra space, this student's personal locker will expand to fit his items. Likewise, you, the device's owner, get to decide how you want the space allocated, whether you want to keep 12 gigabytes of photos and 6 gigs of music and 6 gigs of small apps. The choice is up to you.